Okay, I want to talk about peak oil, the peak oil theory, in a way that I think people can actually relate to. Now, a lot of people think that peak oil is all about, you know, the oil is going to run out and it's going to be a crisis because of that. But that's not exactly what peak oil is really about. Peak oil is about world oil production reaching a peak and gradually declining. And as a result, you have a large battle over resources between countries, and you have the standard of living in certain countries declining, and the ability to sustain our population at our current level is severely compromised because of natural gas, because of oil, because of petroleum. We've been able to convert that into electricity that allows systems that can sustain larger populations and encourage larger population growth. Well, of course, you know, if you have a situation where deer, their population is increasing because you are hunting down the wolves, if you remove that variable, if you remove the program that involved hunting down the wolves, then naturally the variable that allowed the population to go up, the deer population to increase, is removed, and therefore, when the wolves are reintroduced, when the wolf population increases, that variable is gone and the deer population must crash at the very least. Well, the same thing's happened with humans and natural gas and oil and things like that. But let's pretend like this sand right here, you know, is oil. Let's pretend this is, let's say it's a big oil find, a big oil field, right? Okay, right here. Let's say the oil goes right here. This is a big oil find right here. And let's say it's easily recoverable. It's not that deep. Let's say they make $100 off this. And they had to spend money on buying the land rights and buying the equipment, the rigs, and all that stuff. And it cost them maybe, I don't know, $45. That's $45 right there, right? $45, but they're still making a profit of $55. It's still a good time for them. Well, with peak oil, it becomes more and more difficult to find areas like that, big oil finds. You actually see a decline in oil finds. And a lot of people say that, oh, we're discovering new oil. One of the things they do is backlog discoveries. Like, they'll find something like this, but then they only claim part of it. They only say they only found like a fourth of it. That way they don't have to pay all the taxes all at once on it. And then later on they'll come back and say, okay, we found this over here. Then they say, okay, we found the third one-fourth of it, and then they claim the rest. So instead of saying, okay, we found this whole area all at once, they say they only found this, then they come back and say they found this, and that way in their new reports, they can always say, oh, we're finding new oil. You know, that's one of the techniques they use. But let's take the same amount of oil, right? And let's say the same amount of oil, just to make it easier so you guys can see it. Let's say they weren't all in one big field. Let's say they were spread out. Some fields bigger than others. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 fields, pretty much the same as that right there. That's a little bit deeper right there. But the difference is now they have to pay for the rights to drill in all 6 areas. So, you know, instead of this cost being $45 overall they get $100 worth of oil out, let's say the cost of each one of these is actually around, I don't know, let's say $20. $20, $40, $60, $80, $100, $120. Now, even though you have $100 worth of oil, by the time you get through investing in all the drills and all the equipment and all the rights to buy the land and all this stuff, it actually ends up costing them more money to drill to get this stuff than it takes than the money they're going to make out of it. So even though you have a scenario where there's oil, it's not very accessible. But let's say this is twice as much as it was. You know, let's say there was more oil there, right? So maybe you have, I don't know. Let's say $150 worth of oil right there, or maybe even $200 worth of oil. Another problem they're dealing with now is not only is the quality of the oil going down, there's more sulfur in the oil, which of course creates a problem because they have to spend more resources on processing the oil, and that drives up their costs. Again, if you got to spend more energy to get the oil out of the ground than the energy you're going to get from the ground, there's no point in drilling. But another problem is that they're harder to get to, which is why they're relying a lot more on deep water drilling. They have to drill through a lot more to get to the oil. So there's more obstacles in the way. And that, of course, drives up the cost. So, you know, even if this was $200 worth of oil, you know, and originally it was like $20 a piece to drill, get all the rights, if it's harder to get to and there's more processing involved, you know, that may be an additional $10, $15 they have to spend on each one of these little drills, each one of these little spots. So the more big fields you have, the better it is. The easier it is to have cheaper oil. The problem we're facing right now, well, at least according to the peak oil theory, is that oil production is peaking, is going down, because there's not enough easily accessible oil. The oil isn't as high quality as it was. It takes a lot more to refine it now. Because it takes more energy to get to it, that is invest a lot more resources. And you gotta understand it. Every time they drill, that's a risk. It could pan out to be nothing. So the more they're forced into a situation where they have to drill more, the more of a risk they're taking, the more it cuts into their profits. And that a lot of that stuff will actually drive up the cost of oil. Now, it doesn't mean it's going to always go straight up. It may have some down points. You know, you may have recessions following big peaks in oil. You may have something like a slope like this once you hit that top. You know, but this is, to me, this is peak oil. Okay, the predominant theory around oil is that after millions of years of dead animals and dead plants being forced deeper into the earth under pressure, oil was formed. I'm convinced that oil is a finite resource. I don't think that it's always being produced at a rapid rate. I think it took millions of years for it to be produced, but a lot of people disagree with me. So share your thoughts. Are you concerned about peak oil? Are you concerned about oil production hitting a peak and there being a fight over resources and a possible population collapse because there isn't enough resources to sustain the population as is, or at least the standard of living? So share your thoughts, share your opinions, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.